Hey everybody, Kartik Subramaniam over at Adhi Schools. I was on a quick 46-minute flight from LAX to Vegas last weekend for a friend's birthday party. Just had a quick turnaround. And I walked through a part of the airport that I was flying out of and stopped at a little bookstore, snack shop, and I picked up, I said, you know, what book can I read in like an hour on the way to Vegas? And I pick up this book, 212 Degrees. And this book was a really quick read. It was definitely under 100 pages. And I had gone to a presentation back in 2007 at Prudential California Realty, where I was a partner in a large commercial real estate office. And I heard a presentation about this book, and it seemed really interesting. And I'm like, man, I can't believe I haven't read this yet. So I picked up the book, got on the plane, and I read the book probably in about, I don't know, 30 minutes. And I was funny because as I was reading it, the reason it's called 212 degrees is that apparently is the temperature at which water boils. So if you have water at 211 degrees, it's just like really hot. But if the water gets to 212 degrees, it's actually scalding and bubbling and it's starting to boil. And the premise of the book was basically that 1 degree of difference could mean the difference between, you know, really hot water and water that boils. So the book basically said, in our lives, if you can take small actions each and every day, this will help you get to a point of success. So it's not this huge, massive set of action that requires, that is a prerequisite for success. Rather, the book implied that little actions taken consistently could basically lead to success over time. And it's funny because last month I read The 10X Rule by Grant Cardone. And the entire premise of that book was that it's not so much little things each and every day, it's massive action that causes change over time, not little actions. And so you kind of have two separate philosophies, right? One book is that, hey, do little things each and every day and the water will start to boil. And the other book, The 10X Rule by Grant Cardone, is like, you need to take massive action, 10 times more action that you might have initially thought in order to achieve success. Now, if I was gonna write a book, I think that first book, The 212 Rule, is probably an easier sell, because you can tell your audience, hey, you don't really need to take big action, you don't really need to try so hard, just try a little harder. And for most people, that's an easier pill to swallow. If you tell someone, the average person anyway, hey, in order to achieve success, you need to take massive action, a lot of people kind of shut down and they don't even necessarily know where to start. But if you can argue, hey, take little steps each and every day, and eventually you'll achieve success, it's kind of a tortoise and the hare type argument. So both of the books are okay. You know, it's funny because the book itself, if you look at Grant's book is like several hundred pages, massive action. You look at the 212 rule, this book is literally like, you know, again, I read it in like less than 40 minutes. The length of the book, I think, speaks a lot about each one of the authors. So I guess for you, it just depends on your personality. Are you an all-in kind of person? Or are you a, you know, kind of slow and steady kind of person? For me personally, the Grant Cardone book resonated with me. I've never really achieved anything by playing small or playing slowly. For me, massive action is just naturally comes to me more than, hey, you know, get up 5 minutes earlier. No, I'm gonna get up like 2 hours earlier or an hour earlier, right? Forget the 5 minutes. I can't, you know, nothing's gonna come from taking small steps. But, you know, I would encourage you to read the book. I didn't like it very much. I mean, I literally read it once and I kind of skimmed through it again. So I read it like 1.5 times. There was just not a lot in it for me. I mean, there was a bunch of like these random fluff motivational quotes that I didn't really like too much. Now, one thing that I did appreciate in the book was that the book used a bunch of sports analogies. It had like, you know, skiing, I think, and, you know, a bunch of track and field events. And the book talked about how a lot of these Olympic events are basically the difference between like getting a medal and not getting a medal was literally fractions of seconds. And as I'm reading this, I'm thinking, that's not small things, right? It's huge focused action the last several years for the athlete preparing for that day that sets the difference between, you know, 1:08 and 1:07, right? That 1 second, yeah, it's a small thing. But what I disagree with the author on is that 1 second represents hundreds of hours, maybe thousands of hours for the athlete to prepare ultimately for that race. So the perception might be that it's a small difference between first place and sixth place, but that 1 second represents massive action taken over several years preparing for those events. So there's a lot in the book that I didn't agree with, but it's worth a read. I think I spent 15 bucks at the airport. If you've read that book, leave a comment below. I'd love to hear from you. Have you read The 10X Rule by Grant Cardone? Perhaps that's a little more up your alley. But comment below. I'd love to hear your thoughts on either of these, and look forward to doing another book review for you guys next month. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram. I'd love to connect with you online and know what you're up to. Also, subscribe to the YouTube channel. It helps me make more videos each and every week for you guys. We'll catch you guys next time, and we'll talk to you soon.